Okay. Listen. I've got something to say about this thing, this energy, this frenetic uncertainty, what we all feel, those latent sleeper senses. Searching for meaning, scheming, looking for words, defining what we learn to feel becomes real. What we learn to feel becomes real. From the cutthroat of an epoch bleeds an eternity. Not knowing elevates fear. Spirits need to aim beyond us for something and someone to blame or to eat. By no real choices, we call relief a release. Versus now. From tsunamis. Data. Desensitization. Sanitization of unknown grief.
Reason. What's there right this
learning to not fear cleanses the soul from frenetic uncertainty. And so many choices that all seem wrong. Too many words without meaning or sound. Someone else's pain always looks better than her. The shame of inhumanity that everybody owns, from losing dreams of peace, falling to complacency, from this relentless uncertainty, selling out to get here to some disease by buying into ego and greed or sloth or pride or lust, envy and anger. Deadly sins? Yes. But without vice, there's nowhere to hide. When truth is eclipsed, instead of light, darkness. Disguise your sins as a heart. Suicide, science, metaphors, and media. Nothing is real. just distortion is repeated. What's the point? What's the point? Of even having eyes, if all that seems and all you feel of this wild energy, someone else devised. Reality bought and sold from the shadows of lost light. This is where time is hidden. To the world's eye, depicting a year's journey through tomorrow's dreams to energy and uncharted territories. Seeing, believing, the middle. Time is finding.